around St. Louis and Busch Stadium, where home runs have been big for the Cardinals this year and in their series against the Pirates so far. Matt Holliday, Yadier Molina, and last night, Lance Berkman capping off a win for St. Louis in the first two games of this four-game set. This afternoon, it's Fox Saturday Baseball, the Pittsburgh Pirates and the St. Louis Cardinals. Along with Bob Walk, I'm Dan McLaughlin, and welcome to Fox Saturday Baseball. Numbers 3, 4, and 5 in the lineup for St. Louis are big, and if you're going to shut them down, you have a chance to win, and that's what the Pirates are trying to do.
Oh, that's for sure. The Cardinals definitely have built a team around the three-run homer. That's what they're looking to do, and their 3, 4, 5 hitters, as tough as it is in baseball, for an opposition pitcher, there's no rest there. You can't pitch around Pujols. There's Holliday. You pitch around him, there's Berkman. They are extremely tough to get through.
Meanwhile, on the other side, it's been 18 consecutive losing seasons for the Pirates. They do have a chance, though, to get to 500, if not have a winning record this year.
Well, the fans in Pittsburgh would love to see this club get to 500, and they have a young core of players. They have Tabata, McCutcheon, Walker. They have committed themselves to pushing toward that 500 mark. They want to bring winning baseball to Pittsburgh, and that's their goal this year.
All right, we're set to go. It's one of the great baseball cities in the country. St. Louis, and it's an NL Central showdown coming up. The Pittsburgh Pirates, the St. Louis Cardinals. Fox Saturday Baseball next. Baseball, 89 degrees, and a gorgeous afternoon here in the Gateway City. The opening pitch is brought to you by Budweiser. Great times are waiting. Grab some Buds. What a difference a month can make for both these teams. Milwaukee has been the hottest team in baseball. And you get a look at where they were July 25th. Pittsburgh and St. Louis were ahead of Milwaukee by a half game, but things have changed because Milwaukee now 9.5 in front of St. Louis and Pittsburgh 17 games back. And I guess first and foremost, Bob, what has happened with the Pirates? Why are they now so far back in the division?
Well, I tell you, Dan, the first 4 months of the season was all about starting pitching with the Pittsburgh Pirates. They really did a great job with that. The bullpen, very solid. Hanrahan having a great year. And just got into a little bit of a stretch there about 2 weeks where the starters just weren't doing the same things that they were doing the first 4 months. And there was especially a homestand there against the Cubs and the Padres where the Pirates pitching just fell off. It was Morton was the only guy that could really depend on at that point. And it got away from him. And from, well, I'd say, a two-week period, it went from tied for first place to 10 games back. It just happened so quickly. And you got to give a little bit of credit, I think, to the Brewers, too. As you mentioned, they are the hottest team in baseball. They just took off. The goal of any team when you're in a pennant race is try and get a little separation when you get toward the end of the year. Boy, if the Brewers got some separation, they just did a heck of a job.
There's a look at Chris Carpenter, the starter today for the St. Louis Cardinals. We're waiting for him to take to the field. He's coming off a masterful performance his last time out on Monday. And the bullpen blew the lead in that game. The Cardinals in the midst of 16 of 19 here at Busch Stadium. So if they're going to get back in the race, they need pitching from Carpenter, and they need to win at home.
Well, that's for sure. Urgency for the Cardinals is off the chart right now. They have fallen way back, as we were just talking about, and it's like a must win every time they go on the field now. They got this long stretch, a lot of home games. They got to make a push now.
Let's take a look at the starting lineup for the Pirates. It's brought to you by Taco Bell. Think outside the bun. And right now, this team collectively hitting .244, fourth from the bottom in the National League. Jose Tabata, Alex Presley, then Andrew McCutchen, Ryan Domann, a switch hitter, along with Neil Walker, then Garrett Jones, Josh Harrison, Chase Darnot, their shortstop today, and Brad Lincoln, the pitcher. Let's get a look at our sprint pitcher profile on Chris Carpenter.
Well, he's been dominant against Pittsburgh really his whole career. 12-2, excellent ERA down in the low twos. It's going to be tough for the Pirates this afternoon. The Pirates build around speed. You saw the lineup, five pretty fast guys in there. But Carpenter really handles the running game well. He is tough to get a jump off, tough to steal bases. At 36 years old, he can still throw pretty hard. When he wants to reach back, he can get it up in the mid-90s at will.
The defense has been a concern this year for the Cardinals. They have committed 88 errors. Holiday and John Jay, Lance Berkman in the outfield. Daniel Descalso, a rookie at third. Rafael Furcal, Skip Schumacher, and Albert Pujols on the right side. And that battery is Chris Carpenter and Yadier Molina, the three-time All-Star behind the plate. Jose Tabata just recently signed a six-year extension, only 23 years old, is their leadoff man. He's hitting .305 as a leadoff hitter on the year, .277 average to go along with four home runs, and he's driven in 19. Contract that could be beneficial for both Pittsburgh and the player.
Mm-hmm, that's for sure. And they really missed him a lot this year. They missed that bat, his run-scoring ability. He spent a number of games on that disabled list with a pulled quad muscle.
Here's a 1-0 pitch from Chris Carpenter. Ground ball left side for Kyle. Deep in the hole. Long throw. Picked by Pujols, and what a play.
Boy, that was an excellent play by Furcal. He's struggling a little bit with the bat this year, but still a very, very good defensive shortstop.
Longtime Atlanta Brave, former Rookie of the Year, picked up from the Dodgers at the trade deadline. The Cardinals and John Mozeliak, the general manager, wanted to try and prove their defense up the middle, and Furcal has done that. Here's Alex Presley. He's hit safely in 17 of his last 22, and on the year he's hitting .319. A lot of young players that Clint Hurdle trying to get an extended look at. Not just for this year, but looking ahead to 2012.
Yeah, that's for sure. Presley, one of those. He really did a great job early in the year before he hurt his hand. Showed everybody that he is ready for the big leagues. Another guy that brings speed, a lot of energy to that lineup.
One ball, one strike. Calling the balls and strikes today, the crew chief, Tim Welke. Andy Fletcher at first. Jim Reynolds is at second. Mike DeMuro down at third. Average age of this lineup for Pittsburgh, just over 25 years old. So they have some young talent, and they have spent a lot on the draft. They're going to try to build up this franchise through their farm system.
Well, you really can't get the premier type player through free agency unless you spend an awful lot of money. And plus, until you prove you can win, I don't think a lot of free agents are looking at Pittsburgh as a place, okay, we want to go there. At least the top guys are. So where else can you get a top type talent? Well, you have to do it through the draft.
There's a line drive hit down the right field line, pulled foul.
And Neil Huntington is done a great job the last couple of years bringing in that top amateur talent into the organization. They have really committed a lot of financial resources to doing so.
Man on deck in many ways, the face of their franchise right now, Andrew McCutchen. Here's a 2-2 pitch to Presley. Hit out of play again.
Andrew McCutchen, definitely the face of the franchise right now. The sky's the limit as to what that young man can do.
Speed and power, great range out in center field. Another 2-2 pitch from Chris Carpenter. Ground ball, two for Cowell. And getting down the line, Presley, and an error on for Cowell.
You see some of that speed that we were talking about with the Pirates. They're trying to build their team around that. There is no time to make a mistake out there at shortstop with these guys going down the line.
The seventh error on Rafael Furcal this year.
That came up, got him in the heel of the glove. He was able to keep it in front of him, picked it up immediately. But again, Presley from that left side, he flies down the line, beats it easily.
Cardinals, as I mentioned before, wanted to upgrade defensively. Ryan Terrio has had the most games at shortstop. Former Cub and Dodger now coming off the bench for Tony La Russa.
Could be looking at the Pirates starting outfield next year with these first three hitters with Tabata and Presley and certainly McCutchen.
See where he ranks in the National League center fielders, one of the best in the game right here. You mentioned the running game, Bob, and you talked about this combination of Carpenter and Yadier Molina. The running game controlled by that bench and Tony La Russa, but you have one of the best defensively behind the plate in Yadier Molina.
Well, that's for sure. This is a tough combo to run on, and you know, one of the reasons that Carpenter has only been successfully stolen is just 14 times, I think, since he's been wearing that Cardinal uniform. And a lot of that is his quickness to the plate, but a lot of that is the Cardinals catching. Made that a hallmark of theirs over the years.
Before Molina was Mike Matheny, who still lives in St. Louis and an instructor for the Cardinals.
He's certainly one of the best defensive catchers around in his day.
No doubt. He finished up his career with San Francisco. Concussions forced him to retire. No balls and two strikes on McCutchen. Presley is running. Chance for Molina. He's got him.
Yeah, got him easy. Is a tough combo. We were just talking about it, and that was no contest. Strong throw by Molina.
Threw out a base runner last night against the Pirates and does so here in the first inning today.
Put it right on the money, but this is the, you know, what the Pirates have to do. They certainly cannot match the Cardinals power-wise in the home run game. They have to look to steal, have to take the extra base.
The high fly ball into right field. Former Astro Lance Berkman puts it away. Cardinals coming up in their half of the first, and that means we'll see Albert Pujols. by Taco Bell. Think outside the bun. John Jay, Rafael Furcal, and Albert Pujols in the first. Matt Holliday, then Lance Berkman, the switch hitter. Skip Schumacher, Yadier Molina, Daniel Descalso, and the pitcher, Chris Carpenter. Brad Lincoln, the fourth overall pick back in 2006. They're trying to get an extended look at him to see what he brings to the table for next year. And our sprint pitcher profile is Brad Lincoln.
And he is certainly trying to impress Clint Hurdle right now, wants that spot for next season. Good athlete, does all the little things well. He can hit, run the bases, field his position well, do those things to try and help win a ball game. And he's been doing a good job this season, keeping the ball down, getting a lot more ground balls than he did last year. Last year, a short time in the big leagues, a little over 50 innings, gave up 9 home runs. This year, he's keeping it down.
Here's John Jay, speaking of extended looks after the trade of Colby Rasmus to Toronto. John Jay, a chance to play center field. Off the end of the bat, hit out to left. Backing up Alex Presley for the first out. The Cardinals lead the league in hitting average-wise at 270. And they're fifth in home runs with 134. What they're trying to find before this season is through, consistency with their starting pitching, figuring out their bullpen, which at times has really been a disappointment for Tony La Russa. But offensively, they know what they've got, especially when you have the man on deck. Albert Pujols.
Now that's for sure. You look at this lineup that they put out there every day and you wonder, man, how these guys ever lose. But, you know, the baseball is a little bit more than just hammering the ball all over the place. That you got to play some defense. You can't give up runs. And they have really had a tough time this year with the double play ball. They have hit into it a ton. And that's got to have hurt their offense a little bit.
In particular, Pujols, personal high in that category, closing in on 30 this year, which may surprise many. Furcal was 2-for-3 last night, batting 231 since the trade, couple of home runs and 6 RBIs. Cardinals, a team that really rely on power in the home run, not so much stolen bases. In his career, Rafael Furcal with 298. That's hit down the right field line and just foul. Meet the defense of the Pittsburgh Pirates. Presley, McCutcheon, Tabata in right field. Harrison, Darnold, Walker, and Jones along the infield. And it's Lincoln and Domet. See, they've turned 137 double plays. Most in the National League.
And sometimes that's a good number. Sometimes it's not. You got to have a lot of base runners to turn double plays. But the Pirates have a pitching staff, especially the starters, that they can get a ground ball when they need one.
The Cardinals, you mentioned it, Bob, they have hit into 141, which is way above anybody else in Major League Baseball. Baltimore at 118, Boston 115. For Kyle, pulls it foul again.
We're talking about how good this St. Louis lineup is. Can you imagine if you put Furcal of a few years ago? At one point, he was a pretty big offensive force. You put him in that lineup, that's what they would like to see. But his hitting has not been so good this year.
2 balls, 2 strikes. And with everything that's gone wrong with the Dodgers, there's an option on the contract for Furcal, so they were more than willing to wave goodbye to him. And it's really going to be an interesting year for the Cardinals and their front office and what they have to do. Shattered bat. And Jones flips to Lincoln for the second out.
And look at like this ball got off the very end of the bat, hit about the last inch. Got just a handle.
Well, you've been around this game a long time, Bob Locke. What is it about Albert Pujols outside the numbers that make him one of the best hitters, if not the best hitter of his generation?
Well, the thing that always surprised me is that he is such a tremendous power threat. Yet he's never been much of a strikeout guy. Usually those things go hand in hand. He hit a lot of home runs, you strike out. Pujols is not like that. He's just a flat good hitter.
Pops one foul and out of play.
And for years and years, it was like people were slow catching on how good he was. They wouldn't walk him intentionally. And that's always surprised me. Why do people continue to pitch to him in situations where he could win the ball game? Maybe not so much in the last couple of years, but early on in his career, people just didn't believe he was as good as he is.
Another broken bat. It's hit to third. And Harrison makes the play. The Cardinals go 1-2-3. And we head to the second. Fox Saturday Baseball.
Is sponsored by Taco Bell. Think outside the bun. Pitcher, I'm Dan McLaughlin. Fox Saturday Baseball from St. Louis and Busch Stadium. Switch hitting catcher Ryan Domet will lead it off. Then Neil Walker, also a switch hitter, and Garrett Jones, who beat the Cardinals on a walk-off home run about 3 weeks ago.
And Domet's been getting a lot of work since coming off the DL. Yeah. Missed a bunch of time, had a collision at the plate.
It's his left ankle, it was fractured. And since that time, though, 17 games, 13 starts, 3 home runs. Is 54 all time for a Pirates catcher, third best behind Jason Kendall and Tony Pena. Spent some years with the Cardinals.
Domet has always had a very interesting bat for the Pirates. A lot of power potential in there.
Nothing at two.
Especially from this side of the plate. Left-handed, he can turn around anybody's fastball.
O-2 pitch by Carpenter. Monday night at a 1-0 lead. Eventually lost that game, and scouts were saying it was the Chris Carpenter of 2005-2006 when he was a Cy Young Award winner. And Bobby had that cutter working, and maybe you can explain to fans at home how the cutter works.
Well, it's kind of a real short slider. It's a fastball that you just come off the side of like you're. And that's how it gets its name. You're like you're slicing off a piece of the ball with your fingers as you're letting it go. There's one there. And where it's really effective is a right-hander throwing to a left-hand hitter like you have right here, where it jumps in on their hands. There it is right there. See the ball? Looks like it's going to be a strike and then moves in. you try to jam those guys with. There it is again.
First strikeout of the afternoon for Carpenter.
Going to see it again. Another cutter. He just comes off the side of the ball. A little bit of a sideways spin. Not so much that you lose a lot of velocity that you would on a regular slider.
You see, since the All-Star break, he's been one of baseball's better pitchers. 4-1, 2.97 ERA.
Ideally, with that cutter, you're only going to lose maybe 2 or 3 mile an hour off your fastball at most.
Another ground ball and a chance for Kyle off the bat of Neil Walker. 2 outs. Talking before how this could be a very interesting offseason for the Cardinals. For Kyle's deal is up with an option, so is Chris Carpenter's. He has an option, but everybody talking in town and across the country baseball wise about the guy at first and what may happen with Albert Pujols.
It's the game's best player, might be a free agent. It's just amazing what that could do to the offseason. Most people that I talk to, they think he's going to remain here in St. Louis. And it's going to take a big check, though, to keep him here.
Real big.
Yeah.
Bill DeWitt, John Mozeliak, Bill being the owner of the Cardinals, along with the representation of Albert Pujols, decided to not have contract negotiations once the season started. So that was it. They put a deadline to it. They have stuck to that. And the three-time MVP is a free agent after this year.
And one thing that always comes up, too, when people are talking about Pujols.
There's a line drive base hit. Garrett Jones went down to get it. Berkman over to cut it off, and Jones is in with a two-out double.
Oh. One thing that people do talk about with the Pujols situation is that Red Sox Yankees already have their first baseman, and how is that going to play into how much money he's going to get? And this is almost, you look at the numbers what he's hit this year, they're phenomenal, but it's a down year for him, obviously. But I don't think that's going to affect the interest in him whatsoever if he does get out on the open market.
He has set the bar so high, and every year he has hit above 300. The other night he hit a home run. That was his 31st. He leads the league, and because of that, it's 11 consecutive years to start his career with 30 or more home runs. Only player to ever do that.
Yeah, I strongly believe he could retire tomorrow, and he's a first ballot Hall of Famer. Just amazing what he has done already in his career.
One ball, one strike on Josh Harrison, third baseman, young player. Two outs, runner at second.
Another one of the young Pirate players, not a lot of power, but high energy. He can run a little bit. I mean, he's always looking to take an extra base. Young players the Pirates have, they're trying to impress with their enthusiasm, and you have to make up for the home runs with defense and speed, and that really is their goal right now.
2-1 pitch, reach for, and a base hit out to left. Jones being waved in, he will score, and it's 1-0 Pittsburgh. A 2-out RBI by Harrison, his 9th of the season, and in this spot he's been very good, hitting above 300 with runners in scoring position.
He gets the bat on the baseball. He hates to walk, especially when he's got a runner out there he can knock in. He wants to get the job done, and he does it there. And even though one of the real fast guys is not the guy that did it, Garrett Jones, by hustling to make that what looked like probably a single off the bat, turned it into a double. That's got him a run. That's the type of baseball the Pirates like to play.
There's Chase d'Arnaud out of Pepperdine University. Spent all of last season at AAA.
There's that play again where Jones, it's just kind of a little flare over Pujols' head. He turns it on, and just a hustling double getting in the second base. Berkman, a little bit of a bobble out there, gave him the opportunity. Turned it into a run.
Pulled foul. D'Arnaud, another one of those young players they want to get an extended look at. Versatile. He can play shortstop. He can play third. He's also played second.
The Pirates look at Darno as a, maybe a long term answer at shortstop. That's the plan for him. Been a little shaky on defense a couple of times this year early on. He's going to have to get that ironed out, but brings a lot of tools to the game. Another one of those guys that can really run.
One ball, one strike, two outs, runner at first. 1-0 Pittsburgh here in the top of the second. Cardinals year in and year out get some of the best support fan base wise in all of Major League Baseball. They are trending towards 3.1 million tickets sold yet again for a mid-market team at best.
They are an unbelievable baseball town here in St. Louis. Always have been.
1-2 pitch by Carpenter. Got him on the cutter. World famous Gateway Arch, downtown St. Louis, the gateway to the West. Presented by Gillette, is sponsored by Budweiser. Great times are waiting. Grab some Buds. Time now for today's four keys to the game.
Well, we talked a lot about the power, how the Cardinals like to win. Obviously, if you beat them, you got to keep them in the yard. And Lincoln needs to do that this afternoon. No home runs. And for the Cardinals, their bullpen has really been a sore spot with them most of the season. They got to figure out if they do get a lead, how to hold on to it. That's going to be a question mark, I think, for the Cardinals going down the stretch here in September. If they want to have any hopes of catching the Brewers, they got to do a better job in the bullpen.
The Cardinals at home at Busch Stadium. We talked about how well the crowds come out and support this team. They're only four games above 500 at home. Cardinals in the midst of 16 of 19 at Busch Stadium. And they still have six head-to-head meetings with Milwaukee. Matt Holliday fouls one back, one ball, one strike.
And that's the main reason that they still have, hope here in St. Louis and in that Cardinal dugout, is they do have those head-to-head games. And as long as you have that, you always have a chance to do some damage. But besides those, they still have to go out and think win every time they step on the field.
One ball and two strikes on Holiday. Two nights ago, a three-run homer to put the game away after the Pirates had intentionally walked Albert Pujols. He's done that four times in his career. Opposing team as Holiday strikes out, walks Pujols, and Holiday then takes that opposing pitcher deep. He's done that four times.
A good hard curveball that falls off the table. Holiday, like he might have just ticked it as it went by, but it stayed in the glove of Dolan for strike three.
Following up your point, those head-to-head matchups, Lance Berkman telling us before the game that he remembers in 06 when he was with Houston and the Cardinals nearly coughed up a big lead in the Central Division. It would have been one of the greatest collapses in the history of baseball. So St. Louis then limped into postseason play. But after that, they turned that into their world championship of 06.
It can be done.
Berkman with a home run last night. Switch hitter. One ball, one strike, one out, nobody on.
I'm sure Matt Holiday, thinking back to his Rocky days, Colorado. Remember that great September run
sure.
they put on with Clint Hurdle at the helm, as a matter of fact. That was an incredible stretch drive.
Off the end of the bat, Andrew McCutchen has to come back in and makes the catch.
Might be a little bit of a tough sun afternoon. Normally he makes it look a little easier than this. He misread that one, able to come back and make the play. You can see the shadow is directly behind him. It's, both center fielders are going to have a tough time with that this afternoon.
Beautiful day here in St. Louis, right around 90 degrees.
And cooled off here a little bit, though, isn't it?
It has, and the other day, Skip Schumacher was playing second base. Said he lost about 7 pounds, had to take an IV after the game. It was scorching hot. It's been that way in the middle of America for about the last month or so. Hot weather. The heat index was 110, we're told, that afternoon.
Well, St. Louis has always been one of the warmer venues to play baseball during the real warm months of summer. The old Busch Stadium was at times like
brutal.
A little bit of an oven.
Brutal.
All that artificial surface.
1-1 pitch to Schumacher. Hit sharply to second. Handled easily by Neil Walker. We play two. And we'll return to St. Louis after a word from your local Fox station.
Baseball on Fox, presented by Gillette Fusion Pro Glide. Chris Carpenter back to work, and a strike to his counterpart, Brad Lincoln, underway here in the top of the third. 1-0 Pittsburgh on an RBI single with two outs by Josh Harrison. Quickly, two strikes.
Once Lincoln gets himself established as a big league, National League starting pitcher, you're going to see a pretty good hitter.
0-2 pitch. And why do you see that?
He can swing the bat very good. Did a lot of DHing in his college years, but I've watched him in the cage. If you didn't know what position he was, you wouldn't know he was a regular pitcher. He really works the bat very well.
A former DH and first baseman in college at the University of Houston, called out on strikes. And first time through the lineup for Chris Carpenter, and he struck out three. Jose Tabata grounded out back in the first on a fine play by Fracal. And a cutter in for a strike.
Tabata kind of slowing things down here a little bit. He wants to take some time off the clock and let Lincoln get a little bit of a rest. He's going to take a little walk around. That's all part of the job of a leadoff hitter. You got to do that.
Ideally, you'd like to see a lot of pitches too.
Mm-hmm.
There's the breaking ball there from Carpenter.
Carpenter, obviously, he realizes it, so right away he's going to go right at him. Jump ahead, 0-2. You can use that against him. Use it to your favor when you're out on the mound, knowing that he's going to try and take some pitches.
Here's a 1-2 delivery. Check swing. And he went. Back-to-back strikeouts for Carpenter. And Tabata, none too pleased with that call.
No, he's not pleased with it at all. He stood there with his hands in the air. You don't see that kind of a reaction very often, but.
Same with Clint Hurdle. He didn't like the call, the manager of the Pirates. Either way, it's two down. The fastball misses in to Alex Presley. Reached on an air by Fracal back in the first and then left stranded. One oh pitch by Carpenter. Two balls and no strikes. This is hit at the deep right. Berkman on the move and makes the catch on the run and on the track. Fine play by St. Louis Cardinal right fielder Lance Berkman, taking the extra base hit away from Presley. Midway through three, Pirates on top.
baseball and at all levels. See how they're making kids' baseball dreams come true across the United States at ChevyBaseball.com. Along with Bob Walk, I'm Dan McLaughlin. We're in St. Louis, Busch Stadium, Fox Saturday Baseball. 7-8-9 for the Cardinals. Pirates with a one-run lead. Two-out base hit by Josh Harrison off of Chris Carpenter back in the second inning. This is Yadier Molina. Broken 0-for-10 slide last night with a home run. And there's a base hit into right. So leadoff hit and the first hit for St. Louis this afternoon. Time now for a DirecTV game break. We take you to the American League at Toronto. And that is B.J. Upton, his 18th home run of the season, a three-run shot. Sam Fold and Evan Liguori were also on base. And Tampa Bay wins it over Toronto 6-5. Get every Major League Baseball game and the most in HD. Call 1-800-DIRECTV. Tampa Bay 7.5 games back of New York for the wild card. Here's Daniel Descalso. And he hits it to the shortstop out there. 6-4-3. Did they get him? Yes, it's a double play.
That is just amazing. Absolutely amazing. Descalso actually going the other way, which is what you would like to see a hitter do to avoid hitting a ground ball. Most of the time when you hit the ball the other direction, you'll lift it in the air. But what happens? A tailor-made easy ground ball double play.
We told you that the Cardinals lead in that department in Major League Baseball.
Antonio La Russa has really got to be scratching his head over the situation with the double plays.
That was number 142. He was telling us the other day that he's tried everything. It seems like when he starts a runner, they hit into a double play, they line out. If he doesn't start, it's a tailor-made.
I know the last couple of nights, ball games against the Pirates, he's been starting a lot of runners and counts that are conducive to that.
Clint Hurdle just saw his club turn their 138th double play. They lead the National League. The Cardinals are on pace to set the all-time record in St. Louis history. You see most in the National League for the Buccos. St. Louis record is 166, and now they're at 142.
Lincoln so far has picked up right where he left off in his last start. After the call-up, he spent some time in the bullpen, going in the starting rotation, pitched against the Brewers, a very good, as you know, offensive club that can pound anybody, and he shut them down for six innings. He's doing the same thing here.
Second strikeout for the right-hander. We play three on Fox Saturday Baseball.
sponsored by AT&T. Here in St. Louis, Fox Saturday Baseball. The Pirates on top by the score of 1-0. Bob Walk, Dan McLaughlin. We're joined now by truly one of the best pitchers that the Cardinals have had the last 5 years or so, and that's Adam Wainwright, who's missing this season. Adam, thanks for joining us. We appreciate it.
Thank you so much for having me on.
You were 19-8 in 2009, last year 20-11, and then you get hit with the Tommy John. How has that gone for you in recouping this year?
Well, it's one of those things where, you know, it's part of baseball. People get hurt, I know that, but it's always hard to miss a season and miss being a part of a playoff contending team. And, it's one of those things where you know you can help the team, so you try to be here for them spiritually and emotionally, but physically you can't do a squat to help.
That's got to be the toughest part. I know how much of a competitor you are. How tough has that been not to be able to be a part of the team, at least between the white lines?
Yeah, I miss competing. I mean, I'm a competitor by nature, and find a way to do that in everything I'm doing, pretty much, even with my wife and kids at home. So, missing competing with this team against this for this great game we get to play for a living. I mean, you know, it's made me realize how good I have it, though. To be honest with you, it's made me realize I love baseball, and I might start get down ball.
And the topspin will get it down. Hard hit ball off the bat of McCutcheon, and a leadoff double against Carpenter.
Hey, Adam,
I'm going to start throwing a little bit sooner than normal, though, if Kyle Loesch keeps throwing these seeds at me.
Hey, Adam, Chris Carpenter's gone through a couple of problems in his life as far as having to get cut on. And is he somebody that you can kind of lean on to let you know what to expect going through this this rehab, getting ready for next season?
Look at those seats. This is unbelievable. I'm just getting pelted. Well, you know what? We've got four starters on this team. four starters on this team, and Kyle Loesch had a similar thing last year that have gone through Tommy John, and all of them have different experiences. So anything I'm going through, I can filter it through one of those guys, and they can let me know how it's going. And by the way, the therapist is working with me. Adam Olson has rehabbed most of those guys too, so he knows how they've responded and got over things. So I always have somebody to lean on, no matter who it is.
What's the toughest thing that you've had to deal with? Is it the physical part or the mental part?
Mentally, it's been okay for me. I knew from the first day of after being hurt that I was going to miss the season. So the thing that I needed to do for this team was to be here emotionally in a positive way, not a negative way. So the Lord has given me peace about it, and so mentally I've been okay. Of course, I miss it, but physically has been definitely the toughest part. I mean, a Tommy John rehab is a long, tedious process. And you go through some aches and pains early on, and right when you start feeling good, you have a little something that humbles you. So, you know, it's a slow process. You have to be very consistent in your workouts and very consistent in your therapist and trust everything that they say. And you know what? They get it right most of the time.
You can go ahead and brush off those seeds off your left shoulder, by the way.
I mean, have you ever seen that many sunflower seeds?
Well, you're next to Loesch, so nothing is surprising here as we get a replay of that slow-mo, the seeds. You just said, quit it, man.
Quit it, man, yeah. Come on.
Adam, the Cardinals this past week picked up the options for you. How much of a relief is that, knowing that you'll be here at least two more years?
Well, I want to be here for the remainder. You know, this is where I came into the big leagues. This is where I've learned and grown as a big league pitcher. This is the city that I've fallen in love with and the team I've fallen in love with. And these fans are amazing to play in front of. So this is where I want to be. So two more years of that is, of course, great. But, you know, it says a lot about the team that they trust me enough in my rehab that, you know, I haven't thrown a pitch yet, and I'm not going to probably almost certainly this year. And they still trust and know that I'm going to be there ready for next year. So it's much appreciated from my end, and I got to go out and live up to that.
Well, I know a lot of fans are
pulling for you across Major League Baseball, certainly here in St. Louis. We are as well, and we'll catch you up soon. Thank you for your time.
All right, thank you for having me.
You bet. Adam Wainwright, real classy guy, and we thank him for joining us, Fox Saturday Baseball. Runners at first and third, a double by McCutcheon. Domet grounded out, productive out to first, advancing McCutcheon to third. The walk to Neil Walker, and now here is Jones. Slaps it the other way, and this could be trouble. That ball will get down. It's into the corner. McCutcheon can walk on home. And Walker will stop at third. It's a double for Jones. And the Pirates add to their lead. It's 2-0.
And there's a perfect example of a hitter going up there thinking, I don't want to hit into the double play. I'm going to go the other direction, see if I can lift the ball into the air. Worst case scenario, I fly out and get a sack fly. Well, he put it down the line. He thought it was going to go foul, it looked like, for a moment as he was staring at it and saw, oh, that's a fair ball. I got a double. And the Pirates in a great situation now to really get some separation. Base hit, they could be up by four.
And Jones, two for two. Both hits have been doubles. And now here is Josh Harrison, who had the first RBI of the game back in the second. Infield is drawn in. A check swing and a strike. This time Carpenter starting him off with a curveball, and we saw that the previous at bat, a lot of cutters against Harrison. Runners at second and third. Outfield is straight away. Infield drawn in for the Cardinals. Strike two.
Boy, how about that? There's an example there why Carpenter has always been such a dominant pitcher. He gets that check swing chase on the curveball and then paints with the fastball inside. Get ahead, come in with that fastball, and do it on the corner. Put it in there for a strike.
Here's the 0-2. Base hit, left center field. One run is in. Here comes another. And Harrison has three of the four RBIs today for the Pittsburgh Pirates, and they lead it 4-0.
And Carpenter might be kicking himself a little bit now. Got ahead 0-2. Probably had him set up for either the cutter or another one of those curveballs. Tried to double up inside with a fastball. Didn't get it in there far enough. Got burnt. 0-2 pitch probably needed to be for a ball off the plate, not in there on the corner. And Harrison didn't hit all that hard, but he didn't have to knock in two runs. And Pirates in great shape now.
Four of the five that Carpenter is seen here in the top of the fourth have reached base. Here's Chase d'Arnaud. When the Cardinals look back at this season and wonder why, if they don't get into postseason play, much of it will hinge on the injury of Adam Wainwright.
Oh, sure.
It's where it all began. And so about a month ago, right in the thick of things up the Central Division.
As much as it's fun to watch all those home runs and, you know, all that kind of stuff about the offense, the fans, you know, love that. But when it comes to winning, it's all about the pitchers, especially the starting pitching.
Bob, you talked about the success that Carpenter has had in his career against the Pirates. Last 22 innings pitched at home against Pittsburgh. There's a called third strike. One earned run spanning three games, and today already 3 1/3 and four earned runs.
Yeah, he has really dominated the Pirates basically ever since he came into the Central Division, coming over with the Blue Jays.
Carpenter gets his fifth strikeout. Now he'll deal with the pitcher Lincoln, who struck out back in the third.
Now he's reaching back a little bit. He moved that velocity up to 93. He can still hit 94. I've seen him do that many a time. Tried to throw the cutter. It looked like he came out around that one a little too much. Left it outside.
One ball, one strike. Outfield shallow and shading Lincoln a bit to left field. And he hits it into right. Berkman on the move. Can't get it. Drops in for a base hit. Harrison all the way from first will score. Lincoln helping his cause. And it's 5-0 Pittsburgh.
He certainly can swing the bat. going to be doing that an awful lot. The reputation of a good hitter is going to get around baseball once he does get solidified in a rotation.
Reaction of Carpenter.
He is not happy, maybe a little bit surprised at how Lincoln could swing the bat. Got his attention. Anytime an opposing pitcher burns you like that, you know, you look down, you start shaking your head. How did that happen?
Four hits and a walk and four runs in this inning. It's added up to a 5-run Pittsburgh lead. Back to the top of the lineup. Eighth man to come to the dish. Tabata, who is 0 for 2. He's grounded out to short and also struck out. Most earned runs that Chris Carpenter has allowed against Pittsburgh in 19 career starts here this afternoon. The 2-0 pitch. Two balls and one strike.
And this is really when they could least afford him having a game like this.
Trying to hang on and just have a hope in the race in the NL Central.
They have to stay in striking distance because they do have those heads up matches we were talking about earlier. That can go to six games. That could be used as a big swing. Although the way the Brewers are playing right now, just because you have six games with them, doesn't mean much of anything. The Brewers have learned to win in a few different ways now. They used to just be all about slugging. They have fixed their pitching to where they can win a pitcher's duel now.
K-Rod in the eighth, and there's another walk. Axford in the ninth, and then they picked up Markham and Greinke in the offseason. Mm-hmm. But it's also a team, Bob, that does not lose at home. They are 48 and 16 at home. So you think about this one counts in the All-Star game. Well, it may count if Milwaukee gets to the World Series. This is Derek Lilliquist, who is filling in for Dave Duncan, the longtime pitching coach in St. Louis and in Major League Baseball. Dave's wife going through major surgery, and so he has not been with the club this past week. And Derek Lilliquist, who has been a guy that in the Cardinals organization has helped out a lot of the pitchers that have had rehab issues, especially with Tommy John and shoulder issues, got promoted to the big club this year, pitched in the big leagues with the Atlanta Braves. So he's your pitching coach today.
And no action in the Cardinal bullpen right now. A lot of times you see the pitching coach come out. It's 5-0. They're trying to kill some time and get somebody loose, but that's not the case now.
Here's Alex Presley, and it's runners at first and second. Presley is lined out to right, reached on an error by Rafael Furcal. Pittsburgh 3-for-4 with runners in scoring position today, and a fly ball into center. John Jay going back, and he'll make the catch. Pittsburgh strands two, but they pick up four. And Josh Harrison trying to make an impression for the Pirates down the stretch here. Three RBIs. He's 2-for-2 so far today.
Pittsburgh, 0-1-1 for St. Louis. Bottom of the fourth rolls in at Busch Stadium. Lincoln, his first career extra base hit, part of a four-run top half of this inning.
He's really doing well right now. A lot of times, I like to think of a starting pitcher when he gets a nice cushion, he can really pound the strike zone. He doesn't have to worry about making the perfect pitch here and there. But as well as Lincoln has pitched to the first three, I don't think he should change a thing. Just keep doing what he is doing, because he has really done a great job giving up just one hit against a real tough lineup.
Here's a 1-0 pitch to John Jay. Fights it off. Walker going back and makes the catch.
And Domet putting down that fastball inside, and Lincoln threw it right there. Got all in on Jay's hands. Couldn't even get enough of it to get it over Walker's head. Great pitch.
Neil Walker is a fan favorite, Pittsburgh native. He's an interesting story as you get a look at for Kyle, but Walker, the second baseman of the Pirates, a guy that grew up rooting for Pittsburgh.
He's
drafted as a catcher, then moved to third.
Last year, his rookie year, he was still living with his parents. He went home every night and slept in the bed. He slept in as a kid his whole life. So it's a phenomenal story of Neil Walker being able to play for his hometown.
Here's a 1-0 pitch to Furcal. Slaps it the other way in the left center field. And he's thinking too. McCutchen throwing to second. Offline. Furcal in with a double.
Furcal, if you didn't look at the stat sheet, just watch the last couple of nights and this afternoon, you wouldn't know that he is having a very much off year on offense.
Much of that has been attributed to the injuries he's been dealing with this year, and talking about Furcal. And now it's Albert Pujols grounded out to third. Most recently for Furcal, it's been a thumb issue on his throwing hand. Runner at second, and now Albert Pujols.
Not good for a shortstop, huh?
Got to be able to throw the baseball. Many teams, if this was a tight game and first base was open, they would look at pitching around Pujols, but with a five-run lead, no need to do that if you're Brad Lincoln.
It's tough to look over on deck, though, and see Holiday sitting there and think, oh, okay, I want to pitch to him instead. This 3-4-5, man, there's no answers of what's the right thing to do. The other night, the Pirates did pitch around Pujols. Holiday put the game on ice. And it was Berkman in yesterday's game last night. Big home run in the eighth inning.
Two balls and no strikes. Fights it off and fouls it back right below us. 3-4-5, Pujols, Holiday, and Berkman. They lead the National League in average and home runs.
It definitely is a murderer's row that they've put together here in the middle of that lineup.
The constant, though, the last decade with the Cardinals has been Pujols. And at one point, you had Jim Edmonds, Scott Rowland. And now it's Holiday and Berkman. 3-1.
What a tremendous addition in the offseason Berkman was.
Could be your comeback player of the year.
I gotta think that he's got a lock on that. Going back to the outfield, too. And still getting it done out there.
Here's a 3-1 to Albert Pujols. In the air. Left center. McCutchen makes the catch, and Furcal will stay at second base.
Well, Dan, as you mentioned, that five-run lead, you can go after him. You don't have to really pitch around him. And he fell behind 2-0, and then right there, that center cut in the strike zone. tried to throw a breaking ball in there, got behind 3-1, and again came center cut with a fastball because he's got the 5-run lead, and it turns out to be a pretty much a routine fly. That big lead is really important to a starting pitcher. Makes a world of difference to him, especially when you're facing a lineup like the Cardinals.
Holiday struck out his first time up. Two strikeouts for Lincoln this afternoon. Breaking ball that's tapped foul, and it may have caught Ryan Dolman, maybe on the backswing of Matt Holiday.
I don't know. I think it was the ball that got him. Watch his throwing hand.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
Oh. You know that hurt.
Professional courtesy with the umpires out in front of the plate, trying to give Dolman a little breather and get some feeling back in the hand.
It'll take a while to get some feeling back in that one. The Pirates have had a tough time with that catching position this year. Seven different catchers they've used. Still flexing it.
St. Louis trying to get on the board against Pittsburgh. Inside of Matt Holiday.
I've always wondered why more catchers, since you know you catch everything one-handed, why more catchers just don't leave that throwing hand down, you know, behind their knee or, you know, somewhere, get it in a protective area. But so many of them, they just leave it hanging right out there in harm's way.
Fouled straight back by Holiday. You can see Furcal is getting a tremendous secondary lead. Lincoln really not paying attention to him.
There's two outs there. They'd let him steal third. They wouldn't even cover the bag, I don't believe. You have the middle infielders, both of them, their heels are back on the grass. They're worried about the ground ball that might sneak through to score a run. The two outs, they're not going to even think about holding him on.
1-2 pitch. Holiday spoils it. And it's out of play. See where the shadows will become a factor, especially at home plate, next 15 to 20 minutes or so.
And that hitter is going to be looking out into bright sun. And then that baseball, as it travels toward the plate, is going to hit that shadow. And his eyes, they've adjusted. And the irises, they close down because of that sun. And then that baseball hits the shadow, and it's like it disappears. Makes it very tough to hit when the pitcher is in the sunshine and you're standing in the shadows.
1-2 pitch for college running. It's ripped to third. As you mentioned, he would not be covering the bag, and it pays off as Harrison takes an extra base, a hit away from Matt Holiday. Just a rocket to him. 5-0 after four. on Fox, presented by Gillette Fusion ProGlide. Andrew McCutchen hits it in the air to right field. Lance Berkman on the first pitch puts it away. 1 out here in the top of the fifth. Pirates picked up a run in the second and 4 in the fourth. Tony La Russa has seen his pitching staff, the starting pitchers, all of them in this homestand, have one big inning at which they've given up at least 3 runs, and Carpenter did that in the top of the fourth, and there's a strike to Ryan Domet. 28 pitches last inning for Carpenter. 5 earned runs today. Ground ball to second. Schumacher stays with it, makes the play.
Carpenter's a horse, though. He throws a lot of pitches. Yeah, he is used to working hard every start.
Bobby's a guy that twice this year, and looking at the numbers, has gone above 130 pitches. We're now, pitch counts are looked so hard at, and when you pitched, it wasn't that big a deal, but now it is.
Yeah, everybody pays attention to it a lot. Maybe not so much with Carpenter. I think they probably let him have free rein out there, his status. He's averaging more pitches per game this year than he ever has as a Cardinal.
There's Neil Walker. We told you he's a Pittsburgh native, and Bill Mazeroski helping him work on his defense at second base.
And of course, that's something that Neil Walker, being a black and gold Pittsburgh guy, I mean, he just eats that up working with Maz on the double plays. Neil Walker became a second baseman just last year. He was drafted as a catcher. After a couple of years in the minor leagues, they moved him to third base, and that was his position. That's where he came through the minor leagues as a third baseman. But with the emergence of Pedro Alvarez, he kind of got pushed out of that position, had nowhere really to play. Came up last year, got a shot at second base, and that's it. He took over.
Sent his favorite player, Roberto Clemente, even though he wasn't born when Roberto was playing, said his father was supposed to be on the trip in which Roberto passed away. And he said, without him convincing my dad not to go on the trip, I wouldn't be here. It's a chilling story that he tells.
Well, that definitely would make you a fan. Roberto Clemente really is an unbelievably huge figure in the city of Pittsburgh, not only just baseball, but I mean, he stands for a lot.
2 balls and 2 strikes.
You go to a Pirate game at PNC Park, there is Clemente jerseys all over the place.
Huge statue of Clemente at PNC Park. It's 21 feet high in right field in honor of number 21. Unbelievable throwing arm. Humanitarian, and as you mentioned, means so much to the city of Pittsburgh. 3-2 the count.
Tabata, who plays right field for us now, Jose, he also is a huge Clemente fan. In fact, he has his name tattooed on him.
Wow.
I mean, that's a fan. And talk about how he feels now about playing right field. That's pretty amazing that he is out there where his idol played. Right field for the Pirates.
Pirates trying to turn around 18 consecutive losing seasons. It was just a month ago they were in first place in the Central. This is well hit in the left center field. John Jay going back, looks up, and it's gone. It's a home run for Walker on a 3-2 pitch. 6-0 Pittsburgh.
Takes it out to left center. Walker really not a home run type hitter, but excellent gap power. And at times he will surprise you, as I'm sure Carpenter didn't expect this. Pretty much opposite way, deep.
11th home run for Neil Walker, 413 feet as he picks up his 76th RBI. And that's a base into center field. Jones, 3 for 3.
Walker, really a strong offensive player for a middle infielder. You see a second base RBI guys. He's right there with some pretty big names.
Robinson Cano of the Yankees, Dan Uggla of Atlanta, Neil Walker, then Brandon Phillips, who also plays in the Central Division with the Cincinnati Reds. There's Josh Harrison. Big day for him. 3 RBIs. 2 for 2. It is what makes baseball the great game that it is. You look at the numbers that Carpenter has put up against Pittsburgh in his career, and you would not expect this. And it's a 3 for 3 day. That pitch was up. And you wonder if Tony La Russa will now start to get somebody loose in the bullpen.
The home run pitch to Walker was up. That pitch, it's just not Carpenter's day. That's 9 hits now he's already given up in just 4 2/3 innings. He is not himself. Watch the location, the home run pitch. That's a least belt high, right down the middle. Same spot, different pitch. I think that might have been that cutter at the location, belt high, middle of the plate. And Harrison has seen that cutter a few times now. It's not a mystery to him. Third time around.
You don't normally see that, but Tony La Russa going out to visit with Chris Carpenter here in the top of the fifth. 6 runs allowed, most since May 15th, and that was a loss at Cincinnati. Carpenter and Tony La Russa have forged a very close bond throughout the years in this run the Cardinals have had. You mentioned some of the players that they hold options on or could be free agents. One of those is Tony La Russa, and whether or not he would come back and manage the Cardinals for what would be his 17th year. You would have Wainwright coming back. They pick up the option on Carpenter, you would think. And a line drive that's caught by Schumacher, but a lot of it hinges on Albert Pujols. The home run for Walker, his 11th of the year. It's all Pittsburgh. Is sponsored by Gillette Fusion, Gillette's closest. Yep. Central, Pittsburgh Pirates, and St. Louis Cardinals this afternoon. Cardinals have taken the first two games of this four-game series. But Pittsburgh has gotten all over Chris Carpenter today. Nobody warming up for the Cardinals in their bullpen. It's a six-run lead. Lincoln, 5 of 13 first pitch strikes, but yet he has shut down the Cardinals. They have only two base hits as Berkman rounds out to first. Isn't that something, though, Bob, that normally you fall behind like that? That's now 6 of 14 first pitch strikes. Normally, that's not good success.
No, that's one of the big keys to pitching, get ahead. This is certainly a recipe for success, is to always throw strike one. If you look at the stats, the numbers, they definitely will bear that out. But on some afternoons, some evenings, there's more than one way to do it, I guess.
Here's Skip Schumacher, who was pitching earlier this week to save the bullpen for Tony La Russa. And a liner that's knocked down by Walker. Tough play here. Safe at first, Schumacher.
Man, that one might have got a big piece of Walker. He's really reacting out there. That could have hurt him. There it is. A shot, one hopper. Not sure where it hit him, but almost knocked him backwards. Oh, got him right in the chest.
Base hit awarded to Schumacher.
That'd have been a tough error, huh? Look at hit him right in the B.
He says he's all right. He'll stay in the ball game. Brings in Molina, picked up a base hit to right, first time up.
Wow. Hey, you got to do it, though, as a second baseman. You have extra time. If you're over on the left side, you probably play that off to the side, try to pick it, because knocking it down is not really going to do you any good anyway. But at second base, you're going to have time, so you got to get in front of it, keep it in the infield. A lot of times you'll get that out.
Mitchell Boggs getting loose for the Cardinals in their bullpen. And you wonder if he's getting loose to come in for sure in the sixth inning, or is he just getting loose in case Carpenter's spot comes up?
That's probably my guess. Depends on what the situation is when Carpenter hits. They need to get back in the game with a crooked number. They need a big inning.
One ball, one strike on Molina.
This will be Lincoln's 50th pitch he's about to throw right now. That's one thing. He's been fairly efficient with his pitches, been getting a lot of quick outs.
And Molina fights it off into center. McCutchen will make the catch. Two outs. Time now for a DirecTV game break. We head to Minnesota, and that's Justin Verlander trying to get his 20th win of the season. Four strikeouts on the afternoon. Detroit leads it 4-2. Some believe, Bob, that he'll be in consideration not just for the Cy Young, but the MVP of the American League.
I'm sure that he'll get some votes in that regard. What an amazing arm that guy has. It's closer stuff, and he does it for nine innings.
Already a couple of no-hitters under his belt. There's a line shot into right, and it gets down. Schumacher on his way to third. Descalso will stop at first.
And Carpenter's day is done.
Carpenter pulled back, and Corey Patterson, player they picked up in the trade deadline, will be the pinch hitter.
I think Lincoln just went right for the heart of the strike zone with a two-seamer.
Tabada is lucky he was able to keep that, at least just get a piece on it, make sure it didn't get to the wall.
Yeah, it looks like that maybe the ball hooked on him. He played it out to the side a little bit. If he would have went straight toward it, he might have been able to make that catch in the air. The ball was hit very hard, probably did have some hook to it. See how his feet were way in front of the ball. If his glove would have been where his feet was, he might have been able to catch it in the air.
So runners at the corners. Vision on the mound for Pittsburgh here.
And you have a young pitcher out there, and you got a pinch hitter coming up. The first time this afternoon, he's in a little bit of a tough spot. He's got two outs, though. Not uncommon for a pitching coach to come out, and Ray Searidge has had his say. Going to go in. What a job Ray Searidge has done as pitching coach this year for the Pirates.
Really has. And Carpenter, his line, 5 innings, 9 hits, gave up 6 runs, all earned. He walked 2, struck out 5, gave up a home run to Walker. And he's on the hook right now.
The Pirates, the first 4 months of the season, making that great run. It was all about the pitching. And Ray Searidge, a big part of that.
Best opportunity for the Cardinals this afternoon right here. Runners at first and third for Corey Patterson. Bounced around in his career, former top pick of the Cubs. Spent time with Baltimore and Toronto. In the bottom of the fifth of Fox Saturday Baseball, 6-run lead for Pittsburgh.
Out there on the mound right now, you don't want to have any negative thoughts at all. Ooh, might have got a pitch there. But in your mind, you're thinking, I got to get this last out here and do it pretty soon. Because if I don't, if they get a couple of hits, I'm into the middle of the lineup when they can really do some damage. This is crucial to hurry up and get this last out in these next couple of hitters.
Patterson chops one to the right side. Walker, good play, charging. The Cardinals strand 2. And Lincoln is out of the jam. He'll lead it off when we come back on Fox Saturday Baseball. Saturday Baseball rolls on from St. Louis. The Pirates have knocked out starter Chris Carpenter, and it's Mitchell Boggs, a hard throwing right hander out of the bullpen for St. Louis. Been an up and down year for Mitchell. 3.59 ERA, his 45th appearance. When he is right, mid 90s and a very tight, hard slider. Cardinals actually have used him in closing situations this year. And here is the pitcher, Brad Lincoln. He helped his cause back in the fourth with an RBI double. That inning, they had four hits, a walk, and four runs, and they lead this ball game behind nine hits, 6-0.
Dan, there's that shadow you were talking about. And that is when it's really a problem. When you get about halfway there, the ball comes out of that sun, hits the shadow, and very tough to follow the flight.
And four straight, and it's a walk to the pitcher.
Might be tough to see the catcher's glove, too, apparently.
I guess that's the problem, huh?
So important for all pitchers, but especially relief pitchers, to be able to throw strikes when they, right out there, right out of the chute. Sometimes as a starter, you get that room to bend but don't break type mentality. But as a relief pitcher, you got to be razor sharp right from your first pitch.
Albert Pujols is playing behind the runner at first. That's the pitcher. Tabata, leadoff man, is grounded out to short. He struck out and also walked. 0-1 pitch by Mitchell Boggs. Line drive, base hit into right. Lincoln will stop at second, and the first two have reached against Boggs here in the top of the sixth.
He hits a ton of balls to right field. I mean, that is his thing. Base hits to right field. And most guys like that I've seen, they've been the little flares here and there, they shoot it over there a little bit. He hits the ball harder on a line to right field than just about any right-hand hitter I think I've ever seen. He just really commits himself to going that way, and he has figured out a way to really put the head of the bat to it. It's not like a jam shot. It's not off the end. It's right on the screws, line drive to right field.
Runners at first and second. Alex Presley looks at a strike. Descalso is the third baseman for the Cardinals, playing in. A few steps over third and off the line. 3-for-6, a double, four RBIs for Clint Hurdle's club today. The former phenom, Clint Hurdle. Cover of Sports Illustrated when he was drafted by Kansas City, and so much was expected of Clint. Had a long run with the Colorado Rockies, and now first year as the manager of the Pirates.
And really made a huge impression on everybody around Pittsburgh. The team is extremely positive.
1-2. Bob, you've been around it a long time. How do you turn it around? 18 straight years under 500.
You have to pitch better. I think everyone saw that this year. That is by far and away the key for this team. If you want to, really any team, you want to make a difference in that win-loss column, you have to pitch well. Hey, look at the Giants last year. They won it all. And they're not much of an offensive team. They don't hit a lot, not a whole lot of home runs. But they proved again something that's been true for 100 years. Pitching, that's the name of the game. And that's what the Pirates have to do. It doesn't matter that we don't have a lot of offensive firepower, not a lot of home run hitters. If you can pitch and you can play defense, especially in the Pirates ballpark, PNC Park, I think it's a conducive to pitching more than hitting. And that's the key for Pittsburgh.
A 2-2 pitch from Boggs. Ground ball back at him. He'll go to second, out there, on to first. It's a double play. Both teams have turned a double play this afternoon. Pittsburgh, it's been a tough go, obviously. 18 consecutive losing seasons. Vancouver at 15, the Sacramento Kings 15, and then Tampa Bay National Football League with 14.
The Pirates aren't dwelling on the breaking the 500. The goal, of course, is to have a team that compete for the division, like they had up until a month ago. And then the 500 mark will take care of itself. But saying that, it would be nice to get that out of the way this season.
Absolutely.
And not have to to deal with that anymore. I mean, that's, I think, something that the Pirate players will tell you. They're tired of hearing about that. They want a 500 year.
Here's a 1-0 pitch to Andrew McCutchen. Pulled foul. To follow up your point, what you're talking about, first half ERA 3.44, which was eighth in the major leagues for the Pirates. Second half ERA, they dropped down to 23rd. It's nearly five.
Yeah, that's the story.
McCutchen today doubled and scored back in the fourth. Twice he has flied out to right. Two balls and one strike with two outs and a runner at third. Outfield is straight away for McCutchen.
Similar story even, you know, with the Cardinals. They are still on the edge of the race, but inconsistencies in the bullpen. Wainwright going down for the season.
Here's a broken bat. Pass for Kyle. Another two-out RBI base hit, and it's 7-0 Pittsburgh.
It's pitching why the Cardinals are where they're at right now. They have plenty of offense. Ball off the end of the bat, but well placed. For Kyle, got a piece of it. Not enough.
Ryan Domet 0 for 3. All Pittsburgh here in game 3 of this series. Box started the inning by walking the pitcher. Single to Tabata. Then he got the double play. And McCutchen with two out singles, and he picks up his 77th RBI of the year. Two-hit day. He had three hits yesterday. Ground ball right side. Schumacher there. The Pirates add to their lead. It's 7-0. The Cardinals have the top of the lineup coming up. Ball, Bob Walk, Dan McLaughlin at Busch Stadium. And it's all Pirates today, 7-0. They've had an 11-hit attack, 9 of those against Chris Carpenter. But really the story that's developing has been the pitching of Brad Lincoln. Fourth overall pick back in 2006. He's allowed just four base hits and no runs.
He is auditioning for next season, trying to get into that starting rotation, and he certainly is not hurting himself this afternoon, doing it all on the mound and on offense.
It's a Cardinals team that comes in first in the league in hitting, and only four hits today. No balls and two strikes on John Jay, the leadoff man. Top of the order for St. Louis. For Kyle on deck, and then we'll see Albert Pujols. The 0-2 pitch. I think he pulled the string on it. Changeup. And our mini moment is brought to you by Burger King.
It's not all about the strikeout. Really effective pitching is taking the sting out of that baseball, out of the bat. And he's been doing that all afternoon. He's in on the handle. He's out on the edge. Getting a lot of routine outs. And that was a very good changeup on that last pitch for the strikeout.
You're around this Pirates team a lot. You've seen Lincoln before. Is this one of the best outings you've seen from him?
Yeah, well, the last couple have been. He came up for a spot start early in the year. He pitched well in that one also. This season, he has done a fine, fine job. And even in spring training, it was basically between Lincoln and Morton for that number five spot. And it was neck and neck. Lincoln got hit in a spring training game late against the Phillies. I think it was Jimmy Rollins at a line drive off his arm.
He'll make the play here, or won't he? Nice play. He stayed with it. Flips with the glove, and there's two away.
But that set him back. You know, he was right in the hunt, and then he had to miss some time with the contusion on his pitching arm, and he couldn't make the club because of that.
You would figure, too, Bob, when you're the fourth overall pick, the Major League draft in 2006, they're going to give you a long leash to try to develop, try to make it to the major leagues to see what you have. You're not going to give up on somebody like that.
No, sure. We were talking about Wainwright earlier and his Tommy John surgery. Well, Lincoln had that coming right out of college. And first year, he had to go through that, and that set him back a little bit. And that's probably why he's 26 and hopefully just now arriving. And he had to fight that injury bug. Have his elbow put back together.
Two outs and nobody on for Albert Pujols. Pujols is 0 for 2 today. Lincoln has struck out three. He has not walked a man. Giving up just four base hits. Pujols is grounded to third and fly to center.
He is a much more confident pitcher when we've seen him up here this year than last year.
Foul ball.
There's a lot of walks last season. His minor league numbers. He doesn't walk many people in the minor leagues.
Today, 11 of 21 first pitch strikes. 2-1 the count.
Talk about confidence. Well, this has to be a big boost. His back-to-back games against the Braun and Fielder led Brewers, and now going up against these hitters.
And it's a base hit to right field for Pujols. September 11th, the regular season begins with Fox NFL Sunday doubleheader. Falcons take on the Bears in Chicago. Yeah, the Eagles and Rams, Lions and Bucks. All kinds of matchups. Giants, Redskins in D.C., Vikings, Chargers, Seattle and San Francisco, Panthers and Cardinals. Coverage begins Sunday, September 11th. With the Built for Tough Fox NFL pregame show at noon Eastern, 9 Pacific. Check local listings for the games in your area. Steelers 1-1, and they'll play tonight. Rams played in the Governor's Cup in Kansas City. Crossed the state last night. They're 3-0.
The Steelers are at Heinz Field tonight against the Atlanta Falcons. That'll be an interesting game.
U2, the band U2, played at Heinz Field right after they played at Busch Stadium in St. Louis. And the grounds crew here in St. Louis dealt with the hottest week of the entire year after that. And they dug up the entire field and replaced it with new sod. That is smoked into center field and a base hit for Matt Holliday.
And here we go with a 3-4-5 again. But this is when you want to have to face them, when you have a 7-run lead and two outs.
And it brings in the switch inning Lance Berkman.
Well, Danny, we're talking about all the decisions that the Cardinals have to make this offseason. Here's another one. Well, Berkman, you bring him back. He has been so good for the Cardinals this year.
You know, Berkman among switch hitters all time. He's had 357 home runs and the most home runs by switch hitter in Cardinals single season play. Ripper Collins, you know Ripper, 35 back in 1934. Then Berkman and then Ted Simmons. And a lot of people believe that Teddy should be in the Hall of Fame.
Ex-Pirate general manager Ted Simmons.
Right.
How about that shot of Ted there? Interesting look.
It's interesting to say the least. The throwback uniforms last night for the St. Louis Cardinals and Lance Berkman in the eighth inning with a two-run homer that put him on top. And Cardinals helm on, and he got the curtain call. That was number 30 last night. They wore those throwbacks to the 1985 team, a celebration of former center fielder and MVP Willie McGee. Fifth season that a teammate of Albert Pujols has also collected 30 home runs. Jim Edmonds did that three times, Scott Rowland once, and Ryan Ludwig, who's now with the Pirates, did that all-star year 2008. He had 37 that year, and unfortunately for Pittsburgh, Ludwig is out with a back ailment. Derek Lee is out as well.
It's been a rough year injury-wise for the Pirates, to say the least.
See Daniel McCutchen, right-hander, getting loose. Two balls and no strikes.
I would think that Clint Hurdle wouldn't allow Lincoln to give up a lot of runs this afternoon, even with that big lead. He wants to keep that confidence building of the young man.
He's only thrown 68 pitches this afternoon, so fatigue is not an issue at all, but making sure that you leave with that good feeling
right.
of confidence.
Mm-hmm. The Pirates, they have fallen out of the race. There's no getting around that. They have to be thinking about next season.
3-1.
And I'm sure Lincoln is in those plans. You want to really build him up, if you can, throughout the month of September, here at the end of August. Get him into the offseason really confident, feeling good about himself.
A 3-1 pitch to Lance Berkman. 3-2. You're mentioning how Berkman is a free agent, signed a one-year deal with the Cardinals. Wanted to actually go to Houston. They did not want him. He said his second choice was St. Louis. He said the transition to St. Louis was easy because of all the meetings between the teams over the years, even in postseason play. So he knew a lot of the players' personal level with the Cardinals. There's a 3-2 pitch. Runners go, and it's taken for a ball inside.
Berkman's always been a talker over at first base. I'm sure he knew the Cardinals very well.
First walk issued by Lincoln, and a chance here for Skip Schumacher.
You know, one of the things that I thought was most impressive with Berkman is at his age to really work as hard as he did in the offseason to remake his body so he could be an outfielder again. I was pretty impressed with that just before he did all this hitting, just that, you know, he didn't just throw in the towel and say, hey, I'm in my mid-30s, I'm done now. He did the work, and it paid off for him.
But he said that he has not lost weight. He said he has transferred the weight.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's fine.
Yep. Schumacher pulls it foul. Skip is 3-for-5 with 7 RBIs with the bases loaded this year.
He probably needed to transfer a little bit. So.
Big spot for Lincoln in this game. And a chance for the Cardinals to get back in it. Molina on deck if Schumacher can extend the inning. One ball, one strike.
Well, no matter what the score is, normally there always is that one shot where you have an opportunity to get back in the ball game. This is probably the Cardinals shot right here. They're looking for a big hit. They would love something in a gap or down a foul line.
Inning started with a strikeout, then a ground out. Back-to-back hits. Pujols, Holiday, the walk to Berkman. 1-2 the count. Schumacher, another Cardinal whose contract is up after this year.
Got that fastball up and in. And you wonder, too, about the shadows, what kind of an effect it has on making contact with that up and in fastball.
Skip, a versatile player, former outfielder that's transitioned into being a second baseman. The 1-2.
He's only had a strong second half, hasn't he? Since the All-Star break, the knocking a cover off the ball.
Only one player has hit better than Skip since early June, and that's Ryan Braun in all of Major League Baseball.
Now, there's no getting around it. This is a tough team to pitch against.
Here's a 1-2 pitch. Foul ball.
Even though Lincoln's pitch count still in the 70s, he might only be a base hit away from coming out of this ball game.
One, two pitch to Schumacher. Got him. Strikeout for Lincoln. Is fourth of the afternoon. We'll return to St. Louis after a word from your local Fox station. On Fox, presented by Gillette Fusion ProGlide. Bob Walk, Dan McLaughlin back with you. We're at Busch Stadium in St. Louis. And the Buccos with a 7-run lead. Second inning of work for Mitchell Boggs. And he'll deal with Walker, Jones, and Harrison. These three have put up big numbers this afternoon. Walker one for two. And a home run on a 3-2 pitch against Chris Carpenter last time up back in the fifth. Watkins scored in the fourth and is also grounded out.
And he's got the commissioner's name tattooed to his chest.
Took a bad hop that hit him. A hard hit ball by Schumacher. Two innings ago.
Right above that B. Hopefully it didn't hit a button. Oh, what a classic logo that is. The Cardinals sitting on the bats.
Birds on the bat. Here's a ground ball to Schumacher. Makes the play.
St. Louis Cardinals, definitely one of the all-time great franchises. It's kind of like the Yankees of the National League a little bit. They have had a lot of great players, a lot of championships.
The amazing thing is you walk down here in St. Louis into the clubhouse and you run into Bob Gibson, Lou Brock. Stan the Man will come by every once in a while. Saw Ozzie Smith at the ballpark last night, Hall of Famer. Red Shandies dresses out every game, Hall of Famer. On deck, Josh Harrison has been kind enough to wear a microphone for us. Chatty sort, you're going to hear that momentarily, and he's had a nice game. He's 3 for 3.
He's had a lot to talk about.
Yes, he has. One ball and two strikes. His first time up for Harrison. Jones, by the way, 3 for 3. But Harrison had an RBI single. When you hear him talk, he'll be describing that first at bat and what he saw from Chris Carpenter. Hits for the Pirates today. They've out-hit the Cardinals 11-6. The 1-2 pitch. 2-2.
Garrett Jones, one of the hotter hitters in the month of August. He's really come on and reestablished himself. He's more of an everyday player in this Pirate lineup. And getting all kinds of extra base hits.
You can see at times why the Cardinals do have a little bit of a frustration with Mitchell Boggs, as had the hitter 0-2. Now it's 3-2. When he's right, Tony La Russa will tell you he's got nasty stuff.
Oh, he's got a great arm.
Former quarterback in college.
97 mile an hour on that pitch.
The 5, 6, and 7 hitters of the Pirates have 5 of the RBIs. They're 7 for 9. A 3-2 pitch. Left center, John Jay makes the catch on the run. Let's listen in to Josh Harrison, starting with his first at bat.
First pitch cutter, like paint. Yeah. Then he tried to throw it again, and curveball didn't try to throw it again.
You throw a lot of cutters.
Yeah.
One.
Let's get it. Strike two was a ball, man.
So the second at bat, the 2 RBI single, and Harrison all smiles right now.
I like it. To the first pitch cutter, it was like paint.
So 3 base hits, 3 RBIs, a run scored. 2 outs, nobody on.
I couldn't quite hear what he was saying as he took off toward first base. I don't know if he said, let's get it, or I thought for a moment it was let's go. It was skinny. I thought I heard him say skinny, and he was calling Garrett Jones skinny.
No.
Said, let's get it. Let's get the two RBIs in.
Well, he is a fun to watch player. Not really a prototypical third baseman. Not a lot of power there.
Inside, 3-0.
You would think, with the type of player he is, if he does get to be an everyday player at this level, it would be more as a second baseman. Now, that's his other position that he plays. But he didn't see much time there. Obviously, Neil Walker dominates that position.
So he was traded from the Cubs to the Pirates. A deal done by Jim Henry of Chicago, and since that time, past week, he has been relieved of his duties in Chicago. Long run with the Cubs. Began in the mid 90s working in their front office. Three and two the count.
That fastball 98 miles an hour. Bunk certainly has closer type stuff.
Here's a 3-2 pitch. Got him. Strikeout for Mitchell Boggs. Yadier Molina leads it off when we come back. It's all Pittsburgh today.
The Cardinals 7-0. It's Fox Saturday Baseball. Brad Lincoln, the starter for the Pirates. 6 innings, 6 hits. Very effective. Josh Harrison, 3-for-4 with 3 RBIs. And Chris Carpenter, 5 innings, 9 hits. 6 earned runs. A pair of walks as he struck out 5. And now Daniel McCutchen takes over. Right-hander for the Pirates. His 60th appearance of the year.
Hey, he settled in nice to that bullpen role. He has been back and forth a little bit, making starts, but now he has found his niche out there, and really a strong, solid season for McCutchen.
Yadier Molina leads it off for the Redbirds. Daniel McCutchen came along with Jeff Karstens, Ross Ohlendorf, and Jose Tabata. The deal for Xavier Nady. Little flare into right, a base hit. And also a lefty, Damaso Marte. So this has been a deal that's really worked out pretty well for Pittsburgh.
Oh, it certainly has. It really is a turned out well. You get that many quality players for you know, a couple of guys that are going to be moving on anyway. That's what you hope for.
Alan Craig moves to the on-deck circle, which would be Mitchell Boggs' spot. And Fernando Salas, who has been a closer this year for the Cardinals, getting loose. The strike two to Scalzo is bounced into a 6-4-3 double play. And he also singled in the fifth. Alan Craig has had tremendous numbers against the Pirates this year. That's pulled foul, nothing and two. Going back to Chris Carpenter, made the start today for the Cardinals from 0-4 up until this season through 2010. 11-1 against the Pirates with a 2.12 ERA. And if he loses today, he'll drop to 1-2 against the Pirates with an ERA of 5. Bit surprising.
Yep. Numbers, I think his ERA even lower than that here in St. Louis.
Held on to by Descalso, and it's a strikeout. Daniel thought it hit the dirt. Instead, it's a strikeout. And the first out recorded by McCutchen.
It's a close one.
And the correct call. So Alan Craig will be the hitter.
Dan, you mentioned about Craig really hitting the Pirates well this year. I was surprised when I took a look at the lineup earlier today and saw he wasn't in it.
Yeah. As of yesterday, he was hitting above 500 against Pittsburgh this year. Went 0 for 4 last night. Now he's hitting 435 against the Buccos.
He's hitting everybody pretty well. 317 on the year. It's a quality stick.
Tony La Russa would tell you, along with John Mozeliak, the Cardinals GM, they're trying to figure out a spot defensively for Alan Craig. He's played second base. He's played third. He's also played center. So in that regard, he's been out of position. He's more of a corner outfielder or maybe a first baseman. Out at second and out at first. The second double play turn by Pittsburgh this afternoon. 7-0 as we head to the eighth. Sponsored by Sprint, all together now.
and by Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance. Folks here for years have said, meet me at the Stand the Man statue just outside the main entrance here at Busch Stadium. Here is Fernando Salas. And Salas, interesting to see him in this spot here because he primarily has been the closer for Tony La Russa's club. Ryan Franklin started out this year as the closer, eventually was released. Franklin last year, 27 of 29, and he was released back on June 29th. This is Chase Darnot, who's 0 for 3. Salas a year ago had one save opportunity. He was 0 for 1. This year, 22 for 27. And a year ago, Octavio Dotel was the closer for the Pirates, 21 of 26. Now Dotel, after a train with Toronto, is with the Cardinals. And Joel Hanrahan has had a fantastic year for the Pirates, 32 for 35.
It looks like Tony may be looking this last month for a new closer for next year. A little search is going to start. See Salas pitching down 7 runs.
I think that's what you're seeing here. Number one, to get him straight, but also if a save opportunity would come up. Saw last night Kyle McClellan, a St. Louisan pitching for the Cardinals, picked up the win. Former starter this year before all the deals made by St. Louis. Edwin Jackson replaced him in the starting rotation. But they also like Jason Mott, who has been perfect. There's a look at McClellan. Been a good year for him as a starter and a reliever, but then Mott perfect, literally perfect here in the second half. They also like a young pitcher by the name of Lance Lynn, who is on the disabled list, and you may see him get an opportunity or two before this season is through. Another player that's on the DL for the Cardinals is Eduardo Sanchez, right-hander that emerged on the scene earlier this year.
Well, they certainly have some power arms to go to if that's what he's looking for as far as a closer. Cardinals have some fastballs that can bring out of that bullpen at you. Well, I thought it was very interesting in last night's game that in a one-run ball game, McClellan went out there in the ninth inning and really breezed through the ninth. There was no problem for him. It was really quick, easy, 1-2-3 inning. Definitely something going on in that bullpen of the Cardinals.
Here's a 2-2 pitch. Changeup and a strikeout. That's arguably the best pitch that Salas has, is a very good changeup. McCutchen will hit for himself in this spot.
Yeah, this is an excellent changeup. And I think for young hitters coming up for the first time, that might be the toughest thing for them to get used to, is the quality of the changeups at this level. You just don't see the great changeups coming through the minor leagues. Guys in the big leagues, they have them, they know when to use them, and they have control of that pitch. And you got to get used to it.
One ball, one strike. Ooh, up and in on McCutchen in his career, 2 base hits.
All very close, but yeah, I guarantee you, knowing McCutchen, he loved that. He's one of those pitchers that loves to play the game. He would give anything to be a position player.
There's a strike, 2-2. And a hard hit ball to second. 2 away. Sunday, September 11th, the regular season begins. It's a Fox NFL doubleheader, and you will see that young man, Sam Bradford, the number one overall pick from a year ago. Stellar rookie campaign. Was very good last night for the Rams in Kansas City. And week one, they get the Eagles. Coverage begins Sunday, September 11th. The Built for Tough Fox NFL pregame show. Noon Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific. Check local listings for the games in your area.
They have to be extremely excited here in St. Louis to have Sam Bradford as the quarterback. Probably the next young, great quarterback in the league.
Not quite the greatest show on turf.
Could be, though, down the road someday. They don't have the receivers right now, do they?
They don't. That's a big question mark for the Rams. And I would assume this time of year in Pittsburgh, people are focused on high school, college, and pro football with the Steelers.
Oh, yeah. They're tailgating a lot of them right now out in front of Heinz Park.
Nothing in two of the count on Tabata. He's crowded to short, struck out, he walked, and also singled and scored back in the sixth.
Heinz Field, I should say. It's at Heinz Park. It's a beautiful place. It looks like a park.
The new stadiums are tremendous in Pittsburgh.
Yeah.
They've really done a nice job. I don't know if there's a better place than PNC.
There's a lot of people that have shown up at PNC Park over the last couple of years. It's become a baseball destination. If you love baseball and you want to do a little traveling, it's a place you have to go see.
See the skyline of downtown Pittsburgh.
The river that runs Allegheny right beyond the outfield fence.
This ballpark, with the design of seeing the arch in the background, opened up in 2006. There's a strikeout for Salas. His second of the afternoon and in the inning. Gateway to the West. It's 7-0. Sponsored by Verizon, the destination for tablets powered by 4G Lite, LTE, and by DirecTV. Now get DirecTV's best offer of the year. Here's John Jay. Strike on the outside corner. It'll be Jay for Kyle and then Albert Pujols. Second inning of work for Daniel McCutcheon. McCutcheon in relief of Brad Lincoln. He had 13 of 24 first pitch strikes, but only 2-3 ball counts. So that gives you an indication he was very efficient in this ball game today. 1-2 the count on Jay.
He got behind, but then came right back at him.
Cardinals really went all in. They made the trade of Colby Rasmus to Toronto. Gave John Jay a chance to play every day out in center field. By the way, Rasmus just went on the disabled list. A wrist injury. He's played 23 games with the Blue Jays, hitting just 216. Former first round pick and only 24 years old, so tough to give up on an outfielder with a huge upside like Rasmus has. Cardinals got back Dotel and Zabchinski, a lefty that's in their bullpen. Octavio Dotel is up and throwing as we speak. Crowd today of 33,839. 33,839.
I think when you're in the hunt, you're trying to get to the finish line in first place, you have to do what you have to do. And you have John Jay, who looks like a real good young player in his own right. I totally understand the Rasmus situation. Strengthen that bullpen.
2-2. Ground ball to the right side. McCutchen to the bag for the first out. This week at the MLB Fan Cave, a new video was posted on MLBFanCave.com featuring Braves Rookie of the Year candidate Craig Kimbrel and Freddie Freeman. MLBFanCave.com. How about Kimbrel and the kind of year this guy has put together for the Atlanta Braves, their closer? He has been sensational.
Now their bullpen is incredible. The Braves don't seem to get a lot of talk, I guess because they're not in first place. But they could certainly go to the World Series with the pitching they have.
No doubt. First year for Freddie Gonzalez. A lot of people, when you think about Pittsburgh, when they went in their tailspin, think about being in Atlanta and the poor call made by Jerry Meals.
18-inning game. McCutchen came in out of the bullpen. Daniel, he's out there now pitching it. He threw over 90 pitches in that game. It was a fun game to do. It's too bad it ended the way it did.
Another nice play here. McCutchen covering. They get for Kyle by step. So here's what we're talking about. Way past midnight down in Atlanta, and Julio Lugo clearly tagged out, called safe, and that's your ball game.
And that was the end of the game. And it was such a tough emotional loss for the Pirates at that time. A lot of people have pointed to that, saying, well, that was the beginning of the end. I don't buy into that. I think it just, our pitching wore down. That was it in a nutshell. But still, because of the timing in that game and that call at the plate, that's almost like a bookmark on the season as to when the tailspin started. But looking back on it now, it was a fun game really to watch and do. It really was.
Then the next 12 games after that, Pirates go 1-11. They fell to 10 games out, and rough stretch, obviously, when you think about that call. But you know, Clint Hurdle was quick to point out, and he said, look, I know a lot of fans are frustrated. They want to point to that, but you play 162, and yeah. You can't look at one game changing the fortunes of our entire season. 3-0 on Albert Pujols.
Well, we went to Philadelphia right after that and should have won the last game there. We messed that one up, gave it away. And then the Pirates went to home, and they had a homestand against the Cubs and the Padres and got swept in the homestand. So that's what you point to, not to that call at the plate.
3-1. It's easy to say that now, but at the time.
Oh, yeah. It's always, heartbreaking when it happens. It's a beautiful thing about baseball. You play for 6 months. There's so many games. There's all kinds of moments that you can have a redeemer.
3-2, the count on Pujols. Has a base hit to right this afternoon. Also fly to center and grounded out to third. Here's a 3-2. Missed in and a walk to Pujols. Bob Walk, Dan McLaughlin. Walk Saturday baseball, and it has been all Pittsburgh here this afternoon.
Yes, it has. And it was kind of a little bit of a surprise the way that they were able to go out there and handle Carpenter this afternoon. We really thought, I think, going into this one that if the Pirates were going to win this afternoon, it would have to be a close ball game, low scoring. But again, baseball is a crazy sport. You never really know. And they came out and went at a pitcher that has dominated him for a long time and got him out of here early. A lot of base hits off of him.
9 to be exact. 7-0 Pittsburgh. 2 outs, and here's Holliday. Single to center his last time up.
And Lincoln, also the other side of the coin, he did a great job pitching for the Pirates. We talked earlier about keeping the Cardinals in the ballpark, and he certainly did that.
This is popped up behind home plate.
Ooh, nice play. A great catch. Congratulations.
His career 2.33 ERA against Pittsburgh, but today 6 earned runs allowed. They'll play behind Pujols at first, and here's the 0-2 pitch.
If this run score holds up 7-0 right now, it's going to be kind of a hard loss for the Cardinals. They had to think with Carpenter on the mound today, a youngster facing them, making just his 3rd start this season. You got to think you're going to win. And then not only to lose it, but to lose it in the fashion they have, where they've been dominated. It's going to be a tough ride home.
Milwaukee has Chicago tonight. And a called 3rd strike on Holliday sends us to the ninth. Pirates on top, 7-0. Turn it over in the ninth to Octavio Dotel. A record of 0-2, 3.18 ERA, and just over 11 innings of work. Former closer with the Pirates. Guy that has had a tremendous major league career.
I can remember when he was with Houston. Flamethrower.
And a ground ball to Schumacher. Presley retired. Only 12 days until the NFL season begins. Create your fantasy football team today at foxsports.com/fantasy. Play against friends or compete against each other. Fox Sports users, plain easy to play. Sign up today at foxsports.com/fantasy. A couple of guys you may be looking at in your draft: Michael Vick, comeback player of the year, and Sam Bradford, rookie of the year. Here's McCutcheon. He said Houston, Bob, and then I think I remember him with the White Sox, and I remember Dotel with Pittsburgh. I remember him with the Dodgers, Colorado, Toronto, yeah. St. Louis.
He's got a lot of suitcases.
That's just since 2009. He has been with 12 different major league teams. He spent 5 years with the Astros.
Yeah, the reason I bring up the Astros is I can remember it being always a six-inning game with those guys back then. You had Dotel,
Wagner,
Brad Lidge, and Billy Wagner. If you didn't get the lead in the first six innings, you were toast.
It was over.
And those guys came in and they could all throw the ball 95 to 100. Wagner over 100.
He was still throwing hard last year at the Atlanta Braves.
Oh, sure.
From Fairham, Virginia. Billy Wagner, the 1-2 pitch. Swing and a miss by McCutcheon. Good start for Octavio Dotel. Two up and two down. Cardinals will have Berkman, Schumacher, and Molina looking ahead to the bottom of the ninth.
Ray Surridge talking to Carstens. Carstens coming out of the bullpen this year. In early April, going into that starting rotation. And couldn't get him out of there now with a stick of dynamite. Fine, fine season he had.
Chris Resop is throwing in the bullpen for Pittsburgh. 0-1 the count on Ryan Domet. Three ground outs and a strikeout. There's a look at Resop. Cardinals acquired Dotel. Idea being that he'd be a good setup man, especially tough against right-handed hitters. And also an insurance policy if you wanted to use him as a closer periodically.
Ideally, those days are probably through for Dotel, but still a very effective guy to come in seventh, eighth inning of a ball game, be that bridge to the closer.
Does have a save with St. Louis, 1-for-1 in that opportunity. Nothing into the count.
Couple of youngsters there join this afternoon. Josh Harrison on the right, Elvis on the left,
also known as Alex Presley.
They've played a lot in the minor leagues together, coming up now together.
And that's a fair ball. What a play here by Albert Pujols as Dotel covers the bag at first as they take the hit away. Not much to cheer about. The fans enjoy this from the former Gold Glover, Albert Pujols. Bottom of the ninth rolls in when we come back.
Next weekend, college football comes to FX as Charles Davis and Gus Johnson bring you all the action beginning in Norman, Oklahoma. Number one ranked Sooners host the upset-minded in-state rival Tulsa Golden Hurricanes. Good luck. FX Saturday College Football Game of the Week, presented by Russell Athletic in high definition all season long. Also at FoxSports.com, you have Charles Davis's preseason power rankings. Here's Chris Resop. 4-4, non-save situation, 64th appearance of the year.
Doesn't sound like you have a lot of faith in the Golden Hurricanes.
I've got a lot of faith in Oklahoma, put it that way. I look at the positive. But we are extremely thrilled that Fox FX has that package, and welcome in Gus Johnson. Should be a lot of fun.
Getting tagged a couple times, pretty good behind the plate. I feel like he played a football game.
Could be paint drying, and I'll listen to Gus Johnson tell me about it. Pretty good. A lot of fun to listen to, so that'll be on FX.
He lost his sunglasses.
So the leadoff man here is Lance Berkman, who homered late last night. But nothing here today. He's walked, rounded out, and flied out. Resop, a guy that was claimed off of waivers back in 2010 from Atlanta.
Been a nice find for the Pirates. Hard thrower, good fastball. Can reach 95 at times. Lots of strikeouts this year.
Berkman reaching for it, and a fly ball into center. One away. And smooth in center field, Andrew McCutchen.
He's pretty good.
That's why it was surprising to see him on that ball that he basically made a basket catch with.
Kind of had a slow afternoon out there in center field.
Yeah.
He hadn't had to call his name much. He can close down the gaps as good as anybody I've ever seen. Just lightning going left and right.
Made a play earlier this year against the Cardinals in that important series for St. Louis, chasing down a long fly ball that saved the ball game off the bat of Albert Pujols, and he did it last weekend against Milwaukee. One ball, one strike.
I can recall the look on Albert's face as he was rounding first base.
Shocked.
Yep. Fired his helmet off. I thought he had had himself an extra base hit. So did I. So did everybody. And then McCutchen just kind of materialized out there in left center.
One ball and two strikes. Pitching of Lincoln today. Outstanding, the starter for Pittsburgh. Good bullpen work so far. And Schumacher strikes out. No complaints there. Just turns around and heads to the bench. Tonight, strap in and hit the streets for a full hour of nonstop action on Cops, then chill out with the summer's coolest families, American Dad and the Cleveland Show. Crack up the craziness. It all starts at 7 Central on Fox. Final hope for the Redbirds, Yadier Molina. Cardinals have talked about trying to just take care of their own business. The only way to get back into the race, 6 head-to-head matchups with Milwaukee, but this turned into a very poor homestand. Swept by the Dodgers. And after winning 2 straight against Pittsburgh, 2 strikes away from losing game 3 of the series. Talked about 3, 4, and 5 in the lineup of the Cardinals, how you have to shut them down. That means Pujols, Holiday, and Berkman today, 2 for 10, pair of walks and 2 strikeouts. Take that every time.
Oh, I can't say enough about the job Lincoln did, the youngster coming in. You look at his last 2 starts, shut down the Brewers and their big guns, and now today coming in here and shutting down maybe even a better offense than the Cardinals.
Molina, fly ball down the right field line, out of play. 2-2. been a bright spot offensively for the Cardinals. It is two of their seven hits. A 2-2. Broken bat, slowly hit, and this should do it. The Pirates win it as they take game three of the series 7-0.
Really a nice game for the youngsters that come out here and knocked out their nemesis, really, in Carpenter, somebody that they just have not been able to touch for a long time. Put him away earlier and then have Lincoln come out there and do what he did. This is a great win for the Pittsburgh Pirates and a tough, tough loss for the Cardinals.
Now time for the Just for Men Keep Your Edge Spotlight. Brad Lincoln is pitching. That was in the first inning, the broken bats, but he was terrific today.
Yeah, he certainly was. Not a big strikeout game or anything like that, but stayed out of the barrel of the bat. Everything out on the end. You saw the jam shots. Very efficient with his pitches. And really did a great job on both sides of the ball. He contributed on offense as well.
We'll wrap things up from St. Louis right after these messages from your local Fox station.